subscribe to our channel, and hit the bell icon to never miss a video from us.
Hi everyone, today we have with us Miss Jasmine Suri. She's a coach, mentor, keynote speaker, Lego Serious Play facilitator, and Firewalk instructor. She works as a catalyst with leaders across hierarchies to overcome their fears, uncertainties, and doubts, and helps them become their best version in the space of confidence, presentation, trust, and interpersonal skills. She has worked in senior capacities at Serco and Crystalis HRD and is presently the founder of Jasmine Learning Solutions. We seek her guidance to learn more from her experiences. Welcome, ma'am, to the expert interview series and hope we'll have good time together.
Thank you. Thank you very much. So, about, I think, 12, 13 years back, I went for this coaching certification program. And what really intrigued me or really got me thinking was, for every solution, I was able to find the answer by myself. The coach didn't give me the answer. And the coach only asked questions. And when I was able to find that answer for myself, It was very real and very true and seemed like the best solution. And I didn't need to depend on anybody else. So I think that was my first step, that I wanted to learn more about it. So many times leaders in organizations go through a lot of challenges. Businesses, working with teams, power struggles. And what coaching does is it gives the leader a space to connect with the coach for 1 hour, maybe for 3 weeks, 6 weeks, or 6 months, depending on the duration. And this space is a sacred space. It's a 1 hour where the leader is able to just voice their opinion, share what's there in their mind, talk about the problems. And as a coach, I do two things. I ask questions and I listen very deeply. And just by listening and asking questions, senior leaders find their answers. And this can be very life-changing. It also can change the complete way organizations function. And it's a very, very powerful space. Yeah. If it's a leadership training program and not a coaching session, so firstly, what we do is we definitely speak to a few participants from the workshop who are going to join. Understand what are their real-time issues, what are their challenges, what is the sponsor want from the program, and accordingly design a workshop which matches both their needs. But when we're doing a one-on-one coaching, we work with one individual at a time. So we prepare some notes about that person. We have certain where we connect to the core values, their life purpose. So that those notes are always like a reminder for us. We, before the conversation starts, spend about 10-15 minutes, just relook at our notes, see what were the stories shared by that person. So we are able to build a deeper connect with the person. So, you know, interestingly, I think in this place, you know, tools and techniques are definitely there. I think you first need to look at what is your calling. You know, it's, even if you're working as a trainer or a coach or whatever it is, there are a lot of different fields in this. So like I'm working purely in the space of trust and leadership. Okay, I'm working on the softer side. I'm not working on the strategy side. So depending on what your calling is, depending on what you like, you should go deeper in that space. One should never go, okay, you know, you need to do this because this is working well or it's in demand. I'm against that. I think you should first ask yourself what excites you. What is something you would like to study? And then go further into that space. So I use play as a medium. I use Lego work. I use theater. I use new movement. I use drama. I use stories. So mine is very abstract. It's completely through play. But leaders really enjoy and find new answers and new ways of doing things. So I think most important is you want to keep upgrading yourself. It's not about others. It's about learning. It's about clearing your own baggage. To keep developing on your own self-awareness. Make sure you better your listening skills, your questioning skills. Keep on, I think reading is a very important part. Staying up to date with what's happening around. Attending workshops. And most of all, it should be something you love doing. It should not be like a job. It should be something which comes naturally to you.
So, ma'am, is it like developing yourself is the way to uplift others?
Yes, yes. Developing and also clearing yourself. So you have enough space to include others in your life. You should not be bringing your biases to the coaching table. I think one is, you know, you should always dabble with learning. Keep upgrading your skills. Keep reading. And do some assignments just to see how it is. Do you really like it? You don't need to choose this as a path. Spend a year or two just getting your hands dirty. Understanding, do you want to do this? Which part do you like? Which do you not like? And only then decide. It wouldn't be something which I would say you should do this to choose this. I'm against that. But yes, constant learning, reading, upgrading, and getting your hands dirty. Yes. I think to be a learner every day, till the day you die.
Subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon to never miss a video from us.